Hey guys, Kurt Clape, you're here with Teach Mom How. Today we're going to learn how to edit on iMovie, and it's going to be super simple. We're going to break it down step by step, just editing your clip. Let's get started. As we get started, if you missed the on how to get started, how to create your first project, how to understand, then click the link in the description or click the link right here. And it will take you to the beginning video, the beginning iMovie tutorial, to show you how to get started in iMovie. Today's video's purpose is to show you how to make edits, how to, once you've got your video clips in there, how to edit them and go from there. So please watch this tutorial, hit pause as needed, and also please make sure that you share this video with your friends if you find it helpful. Comment below what you learned from this video. That's going to help me know what to do in the next video, and also comment what you didn't learn from this video, questions that this video might have raised or things you have like that. Please comment that so that I know what to make in the next video, or if you just liked it, just let me know in the video, or if you didn't like it, whatever, go ahead and comment. Okay, let's jump right into iMovie. Okay, I'm going to show you a few different ways to edit and add videos to your timeline. So you can preview these video clips that you should have already imported. Again, I'll post the link in the top right corner now if you haven't learned how to import your videos or set up your first movie. But you can view them by scrolling through them like this with your mouse, or you can move your mouse where you want it to start, push the space bar to play it and the space bar again to stop it, or you can select the clip, come over here, and push play, and it will play your video clip. Okay, I usually just scroll through them or use my spacebar. That's the most convenient. Now, in editing my clip, meaning I want to choose the portions of these clips I want to put in the video, I don't want the whole thing, I need to set my in and my out points. This left handle here is your in point. In point meaning where the clip starts. Your right handle over here, the yellow handle, is your out point. Out point meaning where the clip ends. You can set your in and out points two ways that I know of. You can hover over the in point on the left and click and drag that handle. Drag it to where you want. So let's say we want it to start right before she gets to the carpet. Right there. Let go. That's now my in point. It's going to now start where that yellow handle is. And now let's drag the out point, the right handle. I want to end just after she sets the purse down. And that's my out point. Okay. Now to add this to my video, I simply push plus. It will drop it into my timeline. If you use the plus button, it's going to always drop it at the after all your other clips. If I want it per se to go before this clip here, I would click and drag it in front of that clip. All right. And if I drop it in the wrong spot, no big deal. I can click and drag to move it to after this clip if I choose to. Okay, let's delete that for now. Then let's go to this next clip. I'll show you another way to set your in and out point for your clip before you put it into your movie. Again, let's click and scroll and see where we want this clip to start. I want it to start right here. So I'm going to click there, and now I push I on my keyboard. I for in point. No command, no shift, just I for in point. Then I scroll to where I want it to end. Let's end right after that kiss right there. Click right there. Push. I didn't mean to do that. Command Z, by the way, will undo. Okay, let's get this right there. And then I push O for out point. Notice I now have a new in point and a new out point. I click the plus bar and it will drop into my movie, or I click and drag it into my movie. Okay. So if you want to preview the two edits that we just made, you scroll back, you set your cursor, your playhead, to where you want to start playing it, and you push the space bar. That will then play your two clips that you just edited. And cut. Okay? All right. Now you'll notice up here the orange. Those are the orange parts of the parts of the clip that are actually in your movie. Now let's take this last clip here. Let's drag the entire clip down here. I'm going to show you one more way to edit that, depending on what you're doing, is sometimes more convenient. It's you just drag the entire clip here, and then we're going to go through and we're going to cut out, literally like they used to do with film. We're going to splice it and take out the parts we don't want. Okay. Now, if I want to see more or less of this video, I just scroll this handle here. That will zoom all the way in, and this will zoom out. Okay. So find where is comfortable so you can scroll through your video. All right, what we're going to do is we're going to go through and decide what parts of this we want to take out. This is so that if you want to use multiple parts from one clip, this is a good way to do that. Scroll through. Okay, I'm going to have it start right here before she gets to the phone. So I'm going to right click on the clip where I've got my playhead and choose split clip. You'll notice that made two clips out of the one clip. The first part is the part I don't want, so I select it and push delete on my keyboard. Then I'm going to scroll and I'm going to have it go until she gets past, just past the phone. Right click again and choose split clip. By the way, if your mouse does not do a right click, on a Mac you hold command and click and it should do the same thing. It's supposed to anyways, at least with other versions of it, it did. Okay. All right. So I've now got from just before the phone till just after. Now I want to scroll. I want to get so she's a little bit closer. We'll start right here. I'm going to right click. Come on. I got my mouse there. Right click, split clip. Now I'm going to remove this 3 second clip. Whoops. Command Z is undo again. I messed up. I want to remove just that one. I had both these selected. I want to remove just the 3.2 second clip. Let me redo this because I had my playhead in the wrong spot. Okay, so scroll this to where I want it and click so that the cursor's there. Then I right click and choose split clip. Now I select the portion I want gone and delete it. Let's take a look at what that cut looks like by scrolling back, pushing the space bar. Here she's walking from a distance. It cut to where she's a little bit closer. Okay, now I decide how long I want that to go. Let's go to just after that car passes. Click again, right click, and split the clip. Okay, now let's see where we want to start back up again. I'm going to scroll ahead till I get right here to this mid shot. Okay. Click there, right click, split the clip, and now I select and remove by pushing delete on my keyboard, that portion. Now I've got this mid shot, she's going to walk up to a close up. Okay, let's take a look at what that looks like. Come back, push spacebar, you'll see her walking from a distance, cut to a closer wide shot. And that's going to cut to a mid shot and she'll walk to a close up. Boom. All right. One last way to adjust these in and out points is once you put a clip in your timeline right here, you'll notice she gets blurry right at the end. She goes out of focus. We can hover on the right handle, the out point, and we can click and extend it. If there's more, this is the end of the clip, so I can't extend it. And we can scroll it back. So I'm going to scroll it back to just before she starts to go out of focus. Right about there. Same with the endpoint. We can hover over that till we get these arrows and we can shorten it, start it later, or we can scroll it back, making the clip a little bit longer. We just showed you the basics of how to edit. If you need to learn how to create your first project and get your first video set up, click and watch this video. If you need to know how to set up your YouTube channel so you can share your video, click and watch this video. If you need to know how to create a slideshow using nothing but your phone, click and watch. I can never do this. It's always backwards. Click and watch this video here. Okay. Hope that was helpful. Please again, comment your questions below of what you want to see in the next video or of what questions you have regarding this video. And I'll do my best to answer those and I'll create more videos. Hope that helped. Subscribe, like, and share. That really helps me out and makes it worth watching these videos or creating these videos. Whoa.